Okay, good afternoon everyone. We'll go into the next concept, that is the stresses in rigid payment. Okay, in that stresses in rigid payments, we'll see what are the factors. Structural design of rigid payment is governed by following factors. What are those? Loading conditions, properties of subgrade, properties of concrete, external conditions, joints and reinforcement. Okay. Now, in the loading induces the stress. That is obviously when load is applied on the payment, it induces stress, as we have seen in the flexible payment also. Higher the magnitude, higher will be the stress. Standard axle load for design, we are taking it as 8200. Sometimes for converted into wheel load, 4100. Okay. So the number of repetitions, so the number of repetition also affect the performance. Okay, higher the repetitions, lower will be the serviceability index. Concrete suffer fatigue when subjected to repeated load application. It will fatigue means what? When you are applying the load continuous for longer time, concrete will be under deformation. That is we call fatigue. Okay. The wheel load from pneumatic tire is transmitted to pavement over a contact area which is determined by tire pressure. That is okay. Contact area is generally assumed to be circular to simplify the calculation. That area over which load is transferred, that is generally assumed circular. Okay. Three critical load positions. What are those? One is at the interior of the pavement. This is a slab. In this way, the vehicles are moving. Let us assume. This we call it as interior of the slab or pavement. Edge of the slab. This is called as corner of the slab. When you see at the interior, tension will be at the bottom. When the load is applied at the interior of the slab, then tension will be at the bottom. Similarly for edge loading. But at corner, tension will be at the top. When you apply the load, stresses will be induced and tensile stress will be at the top. Okay, so that those are the same things. Load applied interior slab, so it will induce tensile stress at the bottom. Load applied at the edge, this induces tensile stress at the bottom of the slab but parallel to edge. Load applied at the bisector of corner, so there will be tensile stress at the top. Properties of subgrade. Okay. Generally, we call it by the name modulus of subgrade reaction K. Strength of subgrade, we generally call it by the name modulus of subgrade reaction. It is the resistance of soil deformation under pressure caused by bending of the slab. Resistance due against what? Bending. Okay. Can you see this example? Let us consider it is a pavement. Now here subgrade is represented as a spring. Subgrade is represented as a spring. So now subgrade reaction, modulus of subgrade reaction K is nothing but when load is applied, spring will resist the deformation. So in this diagram you can see. So load is applied, the spring is getting compressed. How much compression? That delta. Okay. So we call it by the name pressure per unit deflection. Pressure per unit deflection. When you use bearing plate test of 75 cm dia. When you use it, 75 cm dia bearing plus today. So that we call it by the name modulus of subgrade reaction. Okay. In this graph, what you are in the y-axis pressure is there, bearing pressure. In this one, settlement is there. Settlement is nothing but delta. Pressure is nothing but P. So that K equal to, K is nothing but modulus of subgrade reaction is equal to pressure by delta, pressure by deflection. For design purpose, we take delta as 0.125 cm. So that is why we have represented here. Now we can convert K for 75 cm plate to K for any dia. K for any dia. Okay, using this formula. Generally, K75 equal to 0.5 of K30. This should be K30. Okay, there is a small mistake while typing. So this is a 0.5 times K30. K30 is the modulus of subgrade reaction obtained for 30 cm dia plate. Okay. Now, can see If k value is very very less than 6, then no direct pavement has to be laid. Before that you need to put DLC, dry lean concrete. Okay, after that you can put the normal concrete. Okay, other properties of subgrade which affect the pavement performance are drainage, volumetric change, frost action. These are all things we have studied in the flexible pavement, so that is why I am going a little bit fast. Now, concrete properties, what are those? Compression strength, flexural strength, E, Poisson's ratio, coefficient of thermal expansion, shrinkage, fatigue. Okay. Now, strength, how you are going to generally measure? Obviously, you are taking a flexural strength because slab in a pavement is acting as a flexure member. So, you are taking a beam 15 by 15. So, you are conducting a 3-point load test as you have done in BMT lab. Do you remember those things? So, beam test they are going to conduct and you are calculating the flexural stress, maximum flexural stress, that will be your concrete strength under flexure. Okay. The span equal to 4 times of depth. All these are experimental setup. So, the load is applied at the third point. Do you remember that diagram? Third point. Flexural strength is evaluated as a body is abruptly under bending action. Abruptly under bending action. Now you know this formula for IS456, bending strength equal to 0.7 square root of FCK. For standard things we generally take for M40 concrete FCR equal to 44.27, FCR equal to 45 for M40 grade strength. Okay, like that. Modulus of elasticity is that property, stress by strain. Okay, like that. The E value increases with strength, that is as the compression strength increases, Young's modulus increase, but mu value will decrease, mu value will decrease. Standard values for design purpose, FCR, crushing strength, flexural strength 45, Young's modulus 3, 45 for FCR, Young's modulus 3 into 10 to the power 5 kg per centimeter square. Poisson's ratio 0.15. We generally take these values. Coefficient of thermal expansion is what? For 1 degree Celsius rise in temperature, what is the change in length? So generally we take it as 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 for concrete per degree Celsius. Shrinkage, when it will be helpful? When concrete is fresh, when evaporation takes place, it will shrink, volume will be reduced. So that time tensile stresses will come on the surface. Do you remember this one? Tensile stresses will come due to shrinkage. Fatigue behavior. Fatigue means for a long time repeated application of the load will induce fatigue behavior. When applied flexural stress are so high, micro cracks will develop. There is one term, stress ratio, SR. Generally called by flexural stress due to load divided by flexural strength of the concrete. Flexural stress by flexural strength is generally called it as SR, stress ratio. These are the relationship between SR and N. What is N? N is nothing but fatigue life. For how many years without going into damage, what is the duration? When SR is less than 0.45, then N is unlimited. Fatigue life is unlimited. Okay. When SR is in between 0.45 to 0.55, fatigue life can be given with this equation, with the given equation. When it is more than 0.45, then you have to use this equation, log to the base 10, N equal to 0.9 minus SR divided by 0.0828. Okay. These are the relationship between the stress ratio and fatigue life. Now, what are these external conditions? What are these external conditions? Due to the temperature change, stresses will be induced. That is one point, first point. Temperature change will cause warping stress as well as frictional stress. Due to change in the temperature, during daytime temperature will be more, during nighttime temperature will be less. So that also will create the temperature stress. That will also create the temperature stress. And also expansion and contraction of the slab due to temperature change is also restrained by friction, means when it is going to expand, the slab is attached to the subgrade, so there will be friction, so frictional stress will also comes into place. So there are two types of stresses: temperature stress and frictional stress. Temperature stress we generally call it by warping stress. Okay, what are these joints? Joints,